conventional signs and symbols. We obtain a lot of information in the study of geography, but there is limited space on a map to show all this information. This is a significant drawback in drawing maps. Actually, it is impossible to show on the map all that there is on the ground. It is a convention to use particular signs and symbols to show different things on the map. They are known as conventional signs and symbols. Using conventional signs and symbols, it is necessary to give these signs and symbols in the index. Observe color map number 4 very carefully. Some signs and symbols are used there. The index given at the bottom of the map shows the signs and symbols and what they represent. We can read this map making use of the index. In the map, a big area is shown in yellow. From the index, we see that yellow represents agricultural area. This shows that agriculture is practiced in a large area of this region. In the map, two areas shown in green are easily noticed. Refer to the index to find that green represents forest areas. The main river in this region flows from east to west. This is shown by the arrow in the course of the river. Two tributaries join it from the north. The main river and its tributaries are shown in blue. In the map, rows and columns can be used to show the location of different things on a map. The rows are named using the letters A to J, and the columns are numbered from 1 to 10. In the map, Ajinkyagarh Fort is shown in the block H4. In this way, the locations of many things can be identified. Read the map with the help of the following questions. Which things in the map are shown in blue? Answer: springs, wells, and rivers are shown in blue. Which village has a police station? Which sign is used to show it on the map? Answer: Vargaon has a police station. PS is the sign used to show it on the map. Which sign is used to show the heights of different places in the map? Answer: Spot height sign is used to show the heights of different places in the map. Example: 512. Where is the place with the greatest height located? Answer: The place with the greatest height is located at Ajinkyagarh. Which color represents forest area? Which sign is used to show a reserved forest area? Answer: Green color represents forest area. RF is the sign used to show a reserved forest area. In which direction is the railway line in the map? Answer: The railway line in the map is in the west direction. In which villages do you find a temple and an Eidgah? Answer: In Vargaon, Talegaon, Shindewadi and Pimpalgaon, we find temple and Eidgah. Where is the weekly market held? Explain the location of that village in the map. Answer: The weekly market is held in Sundarnagar. It is located in D3. Which areas on the map have a large number of palm trees? Answer: The areas along the banks have large number of palm trees. In which direction from Shindewadi is Pimpalgaon? Answer: Pimpalgaon is in the south direction from Shindewadi. Which village is located to the southwest of Shindewadi? Answer. Talegaon is located to the southwest of Shindewadi. What is the name of the main river in the map? Answer. River Neel is the main river in the map. Map reading. Understanding the information given in a map by referring to the elements of the map, the title and the index is known as map reading. For example, you can read the color map number 6, India Physical, in the following way. The main aim of this map is to show the physical features of India. This is understood from its title. This map shows mountain ranges, plateaus, plains, rivers, lakes, seas, etc., besides showing the altitude of the different regions. The altitude of the regions is shown by different colors, and the index gives the meaning of each color. The scale shows the scale to which the map is drawn. The parts that are above 1000 meters in altitude are mainly in the Himalayas, southern Sahyadris, and eastern hilly regions of Purvanchal. The heights of the peaks in the Himalayas and the plateaus are given in figures. Some of the peaks in the Himalayas rise above 8000 meters. In the map, the seas, the important rivers of India, and lakes are shown in blue. The names of the main rivers are written along their courses. The letters in the names of the mountain ranges are spaced out to show the expanse of the ranges. Field visit. The field visit is an important method of study in geography. The main aim of a field visit is to actually visit a place in person and find out about its geographical conditions. On field visits, we get an opportunity to make observations and to meet the local people and discuss things with them. Places on the river banks, seashores, sanctuaries, nurseries, marketplaces, factories, railway stations, bus stands, post offices can be suggested for field visits. A model of a field visit to the weekly market is given below. Weekly market. The population of small villages is small too. Hence, they have fewer shops. Such villages have to depend on bigger villages for their purchases. Some big villages hold markets on a fixed day. This is known as the weekly market. Traders from nearby villages come to sell different types of goods in this market. People from the villages come to purchase these goods. They are called customers. Apart from these weekly markets, there are some other shops where buying and selling goes on every day.